attend the program dinner date, one person goes on a date with a number of other people. You'll have to excuse my appalling drawing. And what happens is that at the start of the program, the person will read anything about them. All they do is read their menus and the food contained within each menu. And once they've made the decision who they want to go on, they will choose three of the menus, and it could be any three. So in this example, they choose menus 2, 4, and 5. But I want to look at the probability of how you come to these combinations. And the easiest way to do that is to look at the distribution of the probabilities. So make three choices. Choice number one. And then you have to make choice number two. And then you have to make choice number three. And that gives you your final answer. Now, the probability of choosing any of these random is 1/5, because there are 5 options and each person has an equal chance of being picked. And that, so let's say for example that you pick menu number 2. Now menu number 2 plays no part in the rest of the decision making. And so we are left with 1, 3, 4, and 5. And now the probability is 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, and 1/4. And so let's say this time round, the person picks menu number 5. But this time, you're choosing 1/3, so the probabilities are 1/3. You choose, say, number 4, and so that leaves us with our final selection. Menu number 2 was chosen when the probability of being chosen was 1/5. Menu number 5 was chosen when the probability of being chosen was 1/4, and menu number 4 was chosen when there was a 1/3 chance of being picked. And the way we compute that probability is to multiply all three together, so 1/5 of 1/4. this combination, 2, 5, 4, the probability of that combination being picked is 1 out of 60. Now I use the word combination there, but actually this is a permutation and there's a difference between the two. And we'll see that now, because look at all the different combinations we could have. If we pick number 1 as our starting point, and we go in numerical order, we could pick number 2 first, and then we could pick number 3 next. And then we could pick number 1, we could pick number 2, and we could pick number 4. And then we could pick number 1, number 2, and number 5. And then we could pick number 1, number 3, and number 4, and number 1, and number 3, and number 5, and number 1, and number 4, and number 5. So if we start with number 1 and go in numerical order, these are the possible combinations that we could achieve. But let's say we didn't pick number 1, and we picked number 2 first. Well then, if we're going in numerical order, we can only pick number 3 and number 4, or 2, 3 and 5, or 2, 4 and 5. And if we pick number 3, we can only pick 3, 4 and 5, which leaves us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are 10 possible combinations, but that's only if we go in numerical order. So for example, if we choose number 2, that means you cannot pick number 1. But in this example, we did go in any numerical order. These are the numbers of combinations, but you can see that actually what you might do is go, having decided all of these, you might go 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 5, 1, 5, 3, I do beg your pardon. Go 1, 4, 2, or we could go 1, 4, 3. We could go 1, 5, 2. So these are the different permutations by which these combinations could become if we didn't have to pick a numerical order. So actually, if you go through all of these, and I won't list them all, but what you have to find, and you have to trust me on this, is that if you find all the different ways that these 10 can be ordered, you'll find that there are 60 permutations these 10 combinations. And that means 60 permutations of which was 60. But one more thing to think about. Is this. Suppose those choices could only be made in numerical order. Rather than permutations. So let's say you pick menu number one. Well, now you're left with 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so the probability here is a fifth, a fifth, a fifth, a fifth, and a fifth. And here is a quarter, a quarter, a quarter, and a quarter. Let's say this time you choose menu number 3. Well, because we're going in numerical order, not only can you not pick 1 again, but you can't go back and choose 2, and you can't choose 3 because you've just picked it. So now you're left with 4 and 5. And the probability here is 1/2. Mistake there. So now, it doesn't matter which one we pick, but what we've shown is that for this particular combination, 1, 3, and 5, the probability is a fifth times by a quarter, which we know is 1/20, times by a half, which is equal to 1/40. Let's look at a different one. Let's say this time we start by picking number 2. Well, that means in our next one, we can't pick number 1 because we're going in numerical order, and we can't pick 2. So what we're left with is 3, 4, and 5. Now let's say we pick number 4. nothing left to pick ever. And so the actual probability is 1/3 times by 1 times by 1, which means the probability of 3, 4, and 5 is 1/3, which is essentially a 1 in 3 chance. Because once you've picked number 3, you are committed to picking 4 and 5. Which means if we go back to these two problems, we have to make some adjustments. Because we're not picking a 1/5, are we? Because as our opening gambit, we can only choose 1, 2, and 3, which means this becomes 1/3. And this, we can't pick number 5. So because that one cannot be picked, we're now down to 1/3 again. And then if we look at this one, well, we can still have a 1/2. So actually, the probability of 1, 3, and 5 is not 1/40, but is actually 1/3 times by 1/3 times by 1/2, which is 1/18. And let's look at this one again. Well, again, this is 1/3, this is 1/3, and this is 1/3. And so we're left with thirds again. But again, we can't pick that one, so it has to be 1/2. And so actually the probability of 2, 4, and 5 is 1/3 times by 1/2. Times by 1. And that is 1/6. So you can see that the probabilities are still different, and you are more likely to get this combination than you are to get that combination. But it's important to realise that if you have to pick 3 things in numerical order, it's not as simple as just